chapter 8 and 13, the Bible said, just as you experience, and it shall come to pass that as you were a curse among the heathen, O house of Judah and the house of Israel, so will I save you, and ye shall be a blessing. Fear not, but let your hands be strong. Stretch your two hands. Any curse that has made your hand to be weak, any curse that doesn't allow anything to stay in your hands, any curse that make you gather nothing settle, he said, as you have been from that, and it shall come to pass that as you were a curse, you were a curse among them. Before now, they look down on you. Before now, they conclude your life. Before now, they look at you and say, you have nothing to offer. They say you are a curse among men. Your family is a curse among family. They have concluded everything about your family, your destiny. He said, but from that moment, and it shall come to pass, as you were a curse among the heathen, O house of Judah, and the house of Israel, so will I save you, and you shall be a blessing. Fear not, but let your hands be strong. Stretch your two hands. Stand up on your feet and stretch your two hands. Any curse that has been raised by man, or raised by a prophet, raised by anyone against you, if your amen can travel to this place, let that curse break. I'm not hearing that person. I said, let that curse break. I said, let that curse break. Let that curse break. Stretch your hand. Many of you are celebrating two-bedroom flats, duplex, and you are made to build estates. You are celebrating one car, two car, and you are made to be distributors of car. When your hand is cursed, you celebrate smallness. When your hand is cursed, you celebrate something you shouldn't celebrate. You are made to be a distributor of greatness, but you are celebrating inferior and failure. It is not your fault. You don't understand. Your hand is made to be a blessing, but you are celebrating just little things. Who has cursed your hand? Who has vowed that your hand has nothing to offer? Child of God, I pray for your hand today. I changed the message because I had this dream and I said, God, why? With all this fire, and I called mama and said, I am not happy. See what the Lord showed me. He said, me, there is still a work to do. I said, with all this fire from on Monday, how come that this kind of dream is still showing that the hands of people are cursed, they are empty? Who has emptied your hands? Who has emptied your destiny? Who is saying that you have nothing to offer? Every curse that has made you empty, empty your family, empty your destiny. Today, I break that yoke. That person hearing me, I said, I break that yoke. Somebody stretch your hand. I am provoked. I know what I'm telling you. Very provoked. Very provoked. But I know that the God that I serve, anytime he reveal anything, is an indication that somebody's story is about to change. Every serpent behind the curse in your father's house, behind the curse in your mother's house, they say you were a curse among the heathen, but they say from today is turning the curse to what? A blessing. Anyone that say you are cursed by a prophet or called by a native doctor, or people they call idol worshiper, curse your family. Today, that curse is broken now. That curse is broken now. Somebody worship me in the telly. Anywhere you are connected, I break that curse. The curse that make you to sweat and struggle, where you are meant to be a great man, a big man, a man people should celebrate. Rather, you are walking with another bed food, eating life as if you are enjoying and you are not enjoying, because you are entering, you are suffering from a curse. Who has cursed your family? Who has cursed your dream? Who has cursed your possibility? Every altar that is responsible against your family, any woman that curse a man here, or any man that curse a woman, or a prophet that curse you, or somebody curse you, or where you are coming from, they curse you, I break that curse today. Child of God, thank God the level where you are. But if God revealed to you where you should have been, you will be angry. Am I communicating? Thank God where you are, sir. But if God should
should reveal to you where you should have been.
You will know that you should have more better than where you are. Why? Curse has placed a limit. Has placed smallness, has devoured the men. The men in the house, they become small, few. There are nobody to raise voice. When they talk of money, nobody to come at. When they talk of something great, nobody to do anything. In the family, all of them are just small. They are empty. What is it that have emptied your family? Where is the curse coming from? Stretch your tongue. Today I break that yoke.
I thought I was talking to somebody here. I break that yoke. Somebody shut up them and let like thunder. Any power that says you are an empty vessel, you have nothing to offer. Today I declare with my eye open, I declare the angel of free indeed, the God that I serve. Every cause that said if money does not empty, another one does not come. People look at you that you are a good looking outward woman, you are well to do, but inside you, sir, something is wrong. Inside your body, nothing is happening. You just carry clothes and cover. Many things are going wrong. Every cause challenging your dream, challenging your prophecy, challenging your testimony. Somebody hear me today, I break the curse. That person that can shout the amen, receive your deliverance. I break the curse. I command the curse broken by fire. Somebody shout the amen 3 hot times.